in this short video, I am going to demonstrate the McCabe-Thiele method to find the number of ideal stages required to conduct a binary distillation. So first, let me show a diagram. So this is the distillation column. Now feed is sent in. So feed enters the column from here. Now this feed can be a vapor liquid mix, a subcooled liquid, a superheated vapor, and depending on the quality of the feed, we will have the feed line in the graph. So we will discuss it later on. And this is known as the condenser. So this is the condenser. Now a part of this top product is recycled inside the distillation column and a part goes out. So this part which goes out, let me name this as D, and the part which goes in, let me name as this L. So this composition of this D, suppose this is XD, and the composition of this L, this will also be XD, because these are the parts from the same stream, hence the composition of both of these will be same. Now this bottom, this is known as the reboiler. So this is the reboiler. So this bottoms from the reboiler, let me name this W, and the composition of this is X. Now various stages are required to conduct this distillation. Remember, this reboiler, this is also an ideal stage. This is also an ideal stage. Reboiler is also considered as an ideal stage. Also, depending on the part of this L which has been recycled into the distillation column, there is a ratio which is known as R. This is equal to L by D. This R is known as the reflux ratio. Reflux ratio. This R is known as the reflux ratio. It is equal to L by D. So these are the things you need to keep in mind. Up till now, I hope this is clear. Now we will go into the math which is involved behind this. So first, let us study the McCabe-Thiele assumptions. The first assumption is, the latent heat of vaporization is constant. The heat of mixing between the two phases are negligible. And last is, constant molar overflow or equimolar flow. These are the three assumptions, which are also known as McCabe-Thiele assumptions. So now we will discuss the top operating line equation. Now this is a linear equation. I can write the entire equation, but all we need to know is, first thing is, this line passes through, this top operating line will pass through XD, XD. This point XD, XD, where XD, XD is the mole fraction of the more volatile component of the more volatile component in the distillate. So XD is the mole fraction of the more volatile component in the distillate, and this operating line equation, it will pass through XD, XD, this point. Second thing is the slope of this operating line. The slope of this operating line will be equal to R by R plus 1, where R is the reflux ratio. R is the reflux ratio. I just showed what reflux ratio is in this diagram. This is the reflux ratio R. This is the reflux ratio. It is the ratio of L by D. So this reflux ratio, this R by R plus 1 is the slope of this top operating line. Next is the y-intercept of this line is equal to XD by R plus 1. XD by R plus 1 is the y-intercept of this line. So knowing these three, we can construction of this line in the graph. So we will construct later. Now what we will study is the feed line equation. So this feed line is also known as the Q line. So properties of this feed line, first is, it passes through the point XF, XF. It will pass through the point XF, XF, where XF, XF is the more volatile component in the feed. More volatile component in the feed. It is the mole fraction of the more volatile component in the feed. And second is the slope of this feed line. The slope of this feed line will be equal to Q by Q minus 1. So now the next question which comes is, what is this Q? So to find this Q, we need to know the properties of the feed which is entering the column. Because this Q is given by Q is equal to, so this Q is defined as Q is equal to HV minus HF divided by HV minus HL. So this HV stands for enthalpy of the vapor, HF stands for enthalpy of the feed, HV is enthalpy of vapor, HL is the enthalpy of the liquid. Now, so depending on the position of the feed in this VLE diagram, we will find the values of Q, or we will get various values of Q. So first is, let me name this one. If the feed is subcooled liquid, if the feed is subcooled liquid, then the Q line will look somewhat like this. So if the feed is the subcooled liquid, the Q line will look somewhat like this. If the feed is a saturated liquid, this is case 2, then this is what the Q line will look like. It will be a straight vertical line for a saturated liquid. So next is, if the feed lies between this region, that is a two-phase, a liquid vapor mix, then this is case 3. If it is a liquid vapor mix, then the Q line will lie in somewhere over here. So now fourth case, if the feed is a saturated vapor which is in this line, then the Q line will look somewhat like this. And the last case, if the feed is a superheated vapor, then this is what the Q line will look like. So I have made a separate video on this Q line. This was just an overview, but if you want to find detailed explanation of how we are getting the various values of these lines, attach the video in the description, you can just watch it. So next what we will do is, we will study the bottom operating line. So now instead of writing the entire bottom operating line equation, I will just state the important things. So the bottom operating line, remember this, passes through the point xw, where xw is the mole fraction of the more volatile component in the bottom. So xw is the mole fractions of the more volatile component in the bottoms or the bottom product. So this is one important thing. Another is, it passes through the intersection of the feed line with the top operating line. This is very important. So the bottom operating line will pass through the intersection of the feed line with the top operating line. So knowing these two, we can easily construct the entire McCabe-Thiele diagram. So now we will start drawing stages. So this is what we will do, finding the number of ideal stages for a feed of 70% vapor, considering XF, XD, XW as the mole fractions of more volatile component in the feed, distillate and the bottoms. So this is just a general way of showing how to find the ideal number of stages. In reality, in problems, this value of XF, XD and XW will be given in the question. So first step, what we need to do is, we need to construct a square graph. So this is our square graph. Now the next thing which we need to do is, we need to draw a diagonal line. So this is the diagonal line. So after drawing this diagonal line, a data will be given in the question, which will be y versus x. This is known as the equilibrium data. So we have to plot this, considering this as y and this as x. If we plot it, it will look somewhat like this. So this is what the data will be. This will be the equilibrium data. So this we have to plot. It will be over this diagonal line. So now the next thing is, we have to mark the points, that is this XF, XF, XD, XD and XW, XW. So first is, this XF, XF will lie over here. This XF, XF will lie over here. This XW, XW will lie somewhat over here. And XD, XD will lie somewhere over here. Because the composition, the mole fraction in the distillate of the more volatile component will be the highest. So XD will lie in this upper region. XF, XF will lie over here. And this will be XW, XW. Let me write this. This is XW, XW. This is XF, 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 and this is XD, XD. This is XD, XD. So this is how this will look like. Now, what we studied before, we know that the top operating line passes through the point XD, XD, and it has a y-intercept of XD by R plus 1. This is the y-intercept of top operating line. So in most cases, this R will be given, which is the reflux ratio of the column. So if this r is given, we can put the value of xt, divide it with r plus 1, we will get the y-intercept. So knowing this, I will plot the y-intercept. So suppose I get my y-intercept somewhere over here. Let me draw this with yellow color. So suppose this is where I get the y-intercept. This is xd by r plus 1. So considering the fact that the value of r is known. So the next step is I have to join this xd point with this r by r plus 1 point. So this entire thing is the top operating line, but we do not need the entire thing. We need to cut it off till the point where the feed line meets the top operating line. Now for the feed line, so it is given in the question that the feed is 70% vapor. So feed is 70% vapor. This means we can directly conclude that the value of Q is 1 minus 0.7, which means it is 0.3. This is the value of Q. So if this is the value of Q, I have said before that the slope of the Q line is equal to Q divided by Q minus 1. So if we put this, what we get is 0.3 by 0.3 minus 1, which will be equal to minus 0.7. So if I solve this, the value of this Q will be, the slope value is coming out to be 0.-0.428. So this is equal to, this is nothing but equal to the value of tan theta, because this is a slope, minus 0.428. So if I take tan inverse, the value of theta will be, minus, so minus 23.7 degree. It means that we have to take the angle from the opposite side. So the Q line approximately will be, so we have to draw the Q line from XF. I have already said this before. So if this is the horizontal, then we have to take a protractor and construct this minus 23.7 degree. That is, from this side we have to take minus 23.7 degree. So the line will look somewhat like this. This will be the Q line. So now that we have got the Q line, the last thing is to construct the bottom operating line. So bottom operating line will pass through XW and will meet at the point of intersection between the Q line and the top operating line. So it will be from here to this point. So now we can erase the extra portion of the top operating line, because this portion is no longer needed. This portion of the top operating line is no longer needed, so we will erase this portion. So now that we have the entire operating line, that is this line, so we can easily construct the number of stages. So to construct the number of stages, we will start from this point xd. So this is the first stage. Just draw a horizontal line till the equilibrium line, then draw a vertical line. So this is the first stage. Now again we will do the same thing. A horizontal line and a vertical line. This is the second stage. This will be the third stage. And the fourth stage will be taken up till this XW point. Now since this has crossed this XW point, we need to draw a vertical line from the XW. So now I have drawn a vertical line. So this portion and this portion, we have to take the ratio of these two length. This one is to this one. So the fraction of the fourth plate that is required is the ratio of this length. Suppose this is AB and this is CD. If this is CD, then the ratio AB by CD is the fraction of the fourth plate required. So these are the number of stages. This is how we calculate the number of stages. So now an important thing is the number of stages required is equal to the number that I find from here, that is number from the graph minus 1, because the reboiler is also an ideal stage. Reboiler is also an ideal stage. So this was all about constructing the graph and finding the number of stages required. So I hope you liked this video. Thank you.